Skateboarding sucks. When you skate, it always hurts somewhere. Might be from a primo, a hang-up, a rail sack, a bar of soap, a credit card or a scorpion. Skateboarding hurts so much.
Take me to the fucking doctor, I broke my back!
And if your wrist hurts, you can be sure you will keep falling on it all the time. One day, when falling you think of it, you avoid using your wrist. And then, you fully scorch your back. But yeah, the slams, you'd better not think about it, or you stop skating right away. Skateboarding is horrible. At the spot, there is always some annoying people. Like the gangsters, who sit right on the bench where you want to skate. Kids with scooters. Kids with rollerblades. And kids asking you,
hey, do you know Tony Hawk?
Well, all the stupid kids. Or, you have the teenagers with razor scooters, thinking they are Andrew Reynolds. Or the guy with a brand new board, new clothes, new shoes, trying to be technical, but fails, then keeping it basic and fails again. But the worst, it's when it starts raining. Well, no. The worst is when it's raining and you sprain your ankle. Skateboarding sucks so much when you twist your ankle. You have to wait a month before you can skate again. And so, you watch skateboarding on the web all day long. You only talk skateboarding when you hang out with your friends. Then you go crazy all night long. And so you crash at 5 a.m. and get up at 5 p.m. and you start watching skateboarding on the web again. Well, especially porn. In the end, you make shit every day. Finally, after a month, you can skate again, but it feels strange. Skateboarding drives you crazy when you are on the spot and the madness is coming to you. And there are thousands of reasons to get the madness. Like, there is no run-up, a dog walks by the landing zone, there is a crack right before the first air, there is a weirdo making fun of you, cars are blasting on the street, and this fucking dog keeps coming back. On top of that, you are always scared for your ankle. When you skate, you are always dirty. You spend your time on the ground like bumps, and your hands get filthy. So, you eat French fries with your filthy hands. At night, you stink, and you sleep on your French couch. The next morning, you stink even more. You wear the same clothes, and the couch stinks because of you. Skateboarding is even worse these days because of HD. In the past, kids were filming with a VX1000, made cheap edits, and it was cool. Nowadays, skateboard filmers film much worse on HD. Their edits look like R&B videos, and it's ugly. Blurry, not blurry, blurry, not blurry, pigeon slow motion, pigeon time-lapse. HD is so annoying, and it makes your computer crash when you try to watch some. And the ultimate letdown are the huge contests. Huge contests. It's the opposite of a cool session with your friends. It's a stressful session, filmed on HD, where the goal is to score the most points to get the most cash. Kind of like ice skating, but not so classy at all. Personally, I prefer a cool session with my friends. But sometimes, you call your friends, and nobody answers. Skateboarding is depressing when you skate alone. You go practice flat ground in a parking lot, and you slam, alone. You skate a mini ramp, alone. And you are exhausted after half an hour, because your friends are not there to take turns, because you are alone. Or you find a good set of stairs, and you imagine doing a cool trick, but you are alone. Otherwise, when you are with your friends, skateboarding can be very cool. You can Fall on Your Wrist, Slam on the Ground, Eat French Fries with 50 Hands, Sleep on the Couch, Watch Contest on HD, Do Stupid Tricks, Cruise Down the Street Pretending It's Crazy New York Style, Do Backside Tie Slides, Backside Smith Grinds, Backside Lip Slides, and even Backside Backside. And most of all, you can learn some tricks perfect. And in the end, it's all that stuff that makes skateboarding wonderful. Thank you.